Just what this evening needed. Some ambiance.
Combe never thought he'd be so happy to be back at DeCetto. It felt like...
To be around here somewhere. He wouldn't leave this house.
I don't know what to think anymore. You run into that dick fella.
Who is he? Can he be trusted?
I think he wanted a good guy. Well, you know, like us.
Will he be all right with her coming? Praise the mother.
He don't even know about all that. Just calm down. It ain't time yet.
God. Hurts.
As far as I can tell, Detective Combe seems to be solving problems, not causing.
Just be ready in case he starts anything.
What was that? It's blocked.
Emily will have to die. We can't let her ruin our plans.
I heard.
I don't want to run into the orderlies right now. Not sure I can trust them. I think Dr. Gray might be in there. Perfect time to snoop around his office, though.
Lunacy in the Astarte Artist Colony, a monograph by Yael Klein. In early 1909, the old Derceto plantation outside of New Orleans was turned into an artist's colony. Three famous European artists rent...
There must be a spare key to Dr. Gray's office in here somewhere. I need the key. I don't have the combination for this, but maybe Jeremy did.
Thank you.
The two orderlies still hadn't found Jeremy. Conby figured this was good news. Emily had reminded him about some strange deaths at DeSeto, and Conby wasn't sure who he could trust.
It worked.
The last guest in the
Gray's office, all to myself. Let's see if we can...
Dearest Dr. Manzetti, I find myself in a losing battle with my patient. As I've disclosed in my previous letter, his delusions have him completely captured. It's bad enough that he is torturing himself with paranoia, but his madness turns out to be quite persuasive to others, effectively laying the ground for mass delusion. I am writing to you in hope that you can give me some guidance. Beyond my ambition to avoid devastating surgery on my patient, I have grown worried about my own defenses. The words of my patient are deranged, yet they often resonate with something primitive within me. I have tried photographing his brain with X-rays. It was surprisingly difficult to get good results. Dark blotches on the plates kept obscuring all details. My patient looked at the bad plates and cried out in terror, telling me the dark areas was the shadow of the worm eating him from inside. I could not see anything out of the ordinary.
Figure this guy out.
Where McCarthy has hidden my favorite young.
I have finished tidying up Miss Beauregard's belongings. Dr. Gray was somehow mixed up in this business with the dark man, Detective Conby decided. He had to be. Either Dr. Gray was using the idea of the Dark Man to manipulate and torture Jeremy, or the Dark Man was an actual powerful being possessing Jeremy. And in that case...
Brother, I need you to...
Detective Conby, good to see you again. Solved your case yet?
I'm trying. Hey, Grace, you okay?
Oh, she is just peachy, Detective. Are you looking forward to the Feast of St. John, Grace?
I can't wait.
Kids, ain't they great?
What exactly are you planning for tonight?
Oh, not much. We eat, we drink. Tribute to the wishing tree in the conservatory. The usual.
Then why all the excitement?
There is just something about tonight. Something's different. I think we all feel it. Besides, we got ourselves some new words for the prayer thanks to your buddy Jeremy.
She'll come and turn the world inside out, and things will begin again.
That sounds strangely threatening.
You should come.
Oh, God damn it, Grace. Stay put for once.
peace. Wouldn't want him to get lost. There's something missing.
Jeremy knew that the only one who could help him now was the guest in room number 3. The room seemed to have been empty for so long. But that wasn't allowed to be true. The story needed to be different. To include something from the...
Surprisingly neat. Maybe I've been selling that old barfly short.
Sometimes.
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
Thank you.
take this much more. This has to end. Need the key.
Radiography. Hypothetical psychosurgery.
I do. Thank you. That's better.
Why does this keep happening? What am I supposed to do?
And we're back here. Well, perfect time to have a look around this place. Jeremy's hiding, right?
Hello? Is anyone there?
Jeremy?
I need help!
Wait. Can you hear me?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking
Jeremy,
me.
Where are you?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll figure something out. I'll get the boat running.
Yeah.
boat's wedged itself right into the bayou. If I get the motor started, I could try reversing back into the river.
Jeremy, where are you?
The winch is powered by electricity. I need to find a way to turn it on before I can use it.
Yeah.
The winch is powered by electricity. I need to find a way to turn it on before I can use it. Looks pretty weak. This definitely needs fuel.
Years ago, Frederick needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Come back. Find your focus.
Hey!
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Now everything is wrong. Nothing is in
place. Hey! I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Conby. What do you want?
Were you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
That was Jeremy's self-deceit? A steamboat stuck in the mud? I'm not gonna pretend I understand any of that. What a bunch of psychoanalytic nonsense. Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
Jeremy was calling out for help, but Combi couldn't figure out where the voice was coming from. For a moment, Combi wondered if the boat itself was Jeremy, or if he was below it somehow. It didn't matter right now. Jeremy was clear on one thing. He wanted Combi to...
This is... my room. I recognize I belong here. I know that number. Where's that from? I did this. I wrote that. I know the combination. I carry it with me.
Detective, I have made many discoveries in my case.
How long have I been here? Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Why would McCarthy lock this up? Was he trying to keep Grace from completing the shape? If so, couldn't she have just made another drawing?
What the hell happened in here?
How am I back at the office? Jeremy's never been here. That's me. Isn't it?
How long had it been since I drowned myself in drink and depression? And it all felt so peaceful, slipping away into oblivion. A welcoming dark voice wrapped around.
I think I need to figure out where I'm going first.
He was back in the French Quarter, his office to be exact, a place Jeremy had certainly never seen. It could only...
I remember this case. Some kid got taken by her father, headed out of state, but he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so. Thornhill wasn't a bad man, but he had principles keeping him from handing out information about his deals. So he needed some convincing. Well, every case can't be squeaky clean. Mr. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out. I don't remember this at all, but I can't say it didn't happen.
hotel when Morton gang caught up with me. I owed them money, a lot of it. I can't remember what for, probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed. I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing. It was a stupid move. They'd be back. I found him. In the hotel ledger, I recognized the handwriting of the signature, Ted Stryker. It was him. I could feel it. It was the kidnapper I was hunting. I put on my knuckles and hurried up to his room.
Something about that name, Ted Stryker, rings a bell. Feels vaguely familiar. This room, but I didn't catch up with them here. I must have followed them, but where?